here at the rinks in Irvine for game two of the series with the Chicago Carnage and the Orange County Cowboys. Now, if you're just joining us, ladies and gentlemen, you'll know or understand game one, the Carnage won 5-2. Excuse me, I got it backwards here. It's been a long day. Orange County Cowboys won game one 5-2, ladies and gentlemen. And I'll tell you, they purely outplayed the Carnage. I think the Carnage will experience a little bit of jet lag possibly. But that first game, so that we're clear in what happened, the Cowboys scored 5 unanswered goals, 2 power play goals that they were able to light up. And that all happened. Then Luke Storno dropped the gloves with Nick Silk, who refused to fight him. And Storno was given a 5-minute major for that penalty. The Carnage would score on the ensuing penalty shot and then score once again on the power play when coincidental minors were whistled with a 3-on-2 advantage. So that game ended 5-on-2. Got a little chance to talk to Kenny Van Sky at the end of that game, and Van Sky was none too happy with his team's performance and has vowed that they will play a much better game here with game two. Good evening. We are live from the rinks of Irvine, one of our favorite places to be. First-class facility run by the Anaheim Ducks, who have bought the rinks. It is a great place to be. Beautiful weather out today in the half-enclosed facility. Very happy to be here with game two. With the Cowboys are up in the series 1-0 as they won game one. So if you're just joining us, the Chicago Carnage is in black and red, and the OC Cowboys are in white and red. Eddie Lombaga, the captain out there, finishes his first hit of the game, number 89, and there we go, as the Chicago Carnage will draw blood first and score the game's first goal at 15:01. So it's 1-0 Carnage on a goal there. We'll wait for the official update. We'll wait for the official update on that. And then once we get the score, we'll let you know who got it. But again, the Carnage wearing black and red, and your Orange County Cowboys are in white and red. Two teams here meeting in a very physical first game. Captain Eddie Lombaga takes a little bump there. It's Brandon Brickley now. He'll move that puck over to Captain Luke Storno. Storno back after he had a bout of pneumonia. And he now picks up that puck and accelerates down into the corner where he gets hammered into the boards. Going to get picked. Oh, there's a big hit by Eddie Lombaga as Lombaga just lays into one of the players. And they get up and just say, hey, we're good. Absolutely. Love the facility here. It's a beautiful day out. Like I said, when the sun comes in, it's great on the rink. And, of course, some Chicago fans already yelling at the officiating this afternoon. Our officials are Lee Henson and Brad Dedarian. Chicago's first goal, ladies and gentlemen, was scored by 27. That's Andrew Corvo. And if you didn't know that, Corvo is the brother of Joe Corvo, who is now with the Chicago Wolves of the IHL. So Corvo gets the first goal, and the assist goes to Mike Kowalczyk. So at 15:01, we see Andrew Corvo light the lamp, and Eddie Lombaga is going to go to the box. So Lombaga will get the first penalty of this game, and that will be for the Orange County Cowboys. 13:08 left to play here in the first half. Good evening. Major League Roller Hockey North American semifinals are underway. Orange County Cowboys are leading the series 1-0 as they won game one 5-2. Again, Carnage is wearing black and red. Cowboys are wearing their white and red. Doug Jones, Major League Roller Hockey Commissioner here. It's been a very busy day at the rinks. A lot of people here for tonight's game. I'd estimate we have about 250 people here. Berkeley Hoagland looking good on his prediction that the Cowboys would win this series after game one. Hoagland was very vociferous on the bench, invoking riot with the referees and the Chicago players. After the game, like I said, getting to talk to Kenny Van Skye a little bit. Van Skye said they were going to change their game plan. And just, oh my gosh, a vicious hit behind the net there, ladies and gentlemen. One of the Carnage players absolutely laid out. And I tell you, the hitting is going to pick up now. Everybody's getting into it. Physicality of the game has definitely increased. One of the players had his head down as a goaltender. Andrew Skoron loses his helmet for the Cowboys. And we get a whistle as one of the Carnage players now is going to talk to referee Lee Henson and voice his opinion. That's number 27 for the Chicago Carnage. Andrew Corvo having some words. Chicago's big problem in game one was they spent too much time in the penalty box. Now, hopefully, they've tightened things up. 23 seconds left in the minor to Eddie Lumbaga. Lumbaga in the box, big smile on his face as kids are coming over to say hello to Eddie. As you know, he's the GM of the rink. There's number 11 on a breakaway. That was Bob Svob as he was in. Clean, trying to score. Lumbaga's got 5 seconds before he's back out. And the Orange County Cowboys are going to be back to full strength. There's Lumbaga as he skates down with the puck in deep. Trying to go over to Derek Bowles, number 51. No luck there. Matt White wearing number 54. Pat Tyson on the floor for the Cowboys. Here comes the Carnage on the attack. As Eddie Lumbaga now has it behind the net. He's going to turn around, try and regroup. Again, ladies and gentlemen, if you're just joining us here at the Rinks of Irvine, the Chicago Carnage are up 1-0 on Andrew Corvo's goal. They've made it a 1-0 hockey game. Puck is now being moved behind the net by the Carnage. They're looking to make something happen here after Kenny Van Skye lighting the team up after a game one dismal performance. Like I said, don't know if I attribute it to jet lag or a long drive. Some of the players actually drove here from Chicago. It was 22 and a half hours, maybe even more to get here. There's 15, Skippy Tatasian as he picks up the puck. He tries to do a little finagle inside outside, and that's going to kick over to the Carnage's Robbie Quinn. Robbie Quinn. As the puck goes in front, Jimmy Thompson will kick that out for the Carnage. Number 14 on the floor right now for Chicago Carnage there. Carnage looking to make some things happen. They definitely have to win this game to stay alive in the series. And that was Matt Radinsky, number 14. I apologize. It's been a full day of hockey here at the rinks. And it's been a pretty busy day here. We've enjoyed the activities. Lots of people here. Of course, the best part is they all like to come and stand by the broadcast booth for some reason. I don't know what it is. There's plenty of open seating. Approximately 200 people in attendance. There's a goal by the Cowboys. Looks like number 7 got that one. I'm going to wait for the official word. We'll find out in a minute. Looks like Jimmy Stewart there, James Nathaniel Stewart lit the lamp for the Cowboys. 1-1, 8:22 left to play. If you're just joining us again, the Orange County Cowboys won game one, 5-2, and now have tied this game 1-1 as James Stewart gets the goal. So it is a 1-1 score with 8:05 left to play in the game here in the first half. .754 left in the first half. Cowboys are now going to move the puck up. It's number 23, Chris Thorpe. There's a little bump by Mike Kowalczyk. Kowalczyk for the Carnage. Tell ya, Carnage is really, really playing a much different game than they did in the first one. Like I said, our officials this evening, Lee Henson, Brad Dedarian, thank you all so much for joining us here. We had some technical difficulties here. First time in Irvine, our cord. We were in Las Vegas, and somehow the cord we were using had a short in it as Eddie Lombaga finishes his hit. 1-1 our score, 6:59 left to go in the first half, ladies and gentlemen. Orange County Cowboys, white and red. Chicago Carnage in black and red. If you're tuning in from Chi-Town, say hi. We're on Twitter, and we're also on Facebook. Leave your comments and posts for us. Hope you're enjoying the game tonight, game two of this series. 2 out of 3. If the Cowboys win this one, they eliminate the Carnage. If the Carnage wins this one, we're going to game three, folks. Luke Storno back on the rink for the Cowboys. Storno, number 17, like I said, had a bout of pneumonia, and he is back. And he looked great in game one. Boy, I tell you, Luke Storno is as tough as they come, man. He's got the Duck Dynasty beard going out here, and he dropped the gloves 2 times in game one. There's the Carnage as number 91 tried to put a shot on net. That was kicked up. That was Tim Staley. Staley's shot was kicked out. And a little bump as Pat Tyson gets in the physicality. Cowboys' Berkeley Hoagland, you can hear him all the way across the rink, ladies and gentlemen. 5:57 left to play. If you're just joining us, good evening from the rinks of Irvine. Major League Roller Hockey North American Semifinals. The winner of this series will go tomorrow to play the Breakaway Bullies. As we look at the clock, 5:40 left here in the first half. There's a big hit along the boards. And the Cowboys have a 2-on-1 opportunity. Another big hit is Nick Silk's out there. Silk finishing his hit. There's a cross check to the head by Silk. Boy, I tell you, Cowboys are none too happy with that. Brandon Brickley took a cross check to the head from Nick Silk. And I'll tell you, Storno dropped the gloves with Silk before. He has no fear doing so as he goes by the bench. Candyman Sky sending him out to stir it up a little bit, it looks like, out here. 4:59 left to go in the first half. Thank you for tuning in tonight and joining us, Major League Roller Hockey Live, North American Championships. And we like to send good well wishes to Bill Rowie, who had oral surgery. Bill had a lot of work done on his jaw, and it became numb. He wasn't able to feel anything. He went in, and they next day surgeried him. So Bill's at home, and we send our well wishes to him and hope he's feeling better. He and his wonderful wife, Lindsay, who is always a tremendous big help with Major League Roller Hockey and everything we do. And as I say that, the Carnage had an opportunity there as Ronnie Green, who's one of the leading goal scorers for the Carnage, got the puck, had plenty of time, but for some reason he rushed his shot. Skippy Tatasian there having a talk with Brad Dedarian, who's our second official. Berkeley Hoagland on the bench. Kenny Van Sky on the bench for Chicago. Hoagland had told Van Sky earlier in the week to choke on a bone. And in game one, Hoagland made himself look good, predicting he would beat this Chicago team. But this is game two, folks. Let's see what happens. 1-1 our score. 3:44 left to play in the first half as Skippy Tatasian finishes his hit along the boards. James Stewart with the puck now. He's going to pick up speed, and boy, can he fly. Stewart down the wing, number 7. There's a shot, and the goaltender makes a big save for the Carnage. 1-1 our score. 3:23 left to go in the first half. Good evening from the rinks of Irvine. Beautiful day out here. Temperatures were in the 80s. Rinks had games all day. Kids were playing here. And the stands right now are pretty full. I'd say there's about 200 to 250 people here for tonight's game. Want to thank the Cowboys and the Carnage for bringing those people in. Brandon Brickley shoots. That's blocked by the Carnage as they're going to pick up the puck now and try and bring it out of their own end. 2:53 left in this first half. Want to thank our sponsors this year, Mission Hockey. Obviously, Mission Bauer for everything they do for us. Labeda, Rob Chornabut, and his staff are so good. There's an icing call as Chris Puma, number 12, was unable to play that puck. It was dumped in. Derek Bowles with a long pass. So the faceoff goes down to the Cowboys' end. Berkeley Hoagland looking to make a line change. And he does. Luke Storno will go out. And as we're having that conversation, Hoagland is now yapping at the referee. He's telling him the line change is not good. Now, Berkeley Hoagland pulling some of this stuff. He tried it at Huntington Beach, and he tried it out here. There was an icing call. You're not allowed to change players on an icing. Hoagland knows that, but obviously, again, tries to run the clock a little bit. Major League Roller Hockey rules, you cannot change after you ice the puck. Just like the National Hockey League, you have to keep everybody on the floor. Now Hoagland can change. Derek Bowles with a nice pass to Puma. Puma over to Tyson. Tyson just was not able to finish it. Here comes Chicago. They're going to pick up the puck and slow it down a little bit. Chicago is slowing the pace down. Here's Corvo over the line. He's going to take the puck and flip it over to number 8. That's Brian Berman. There's Berman with the puck. Back over. Corvo trying to get open and receive the pass. Mike Kowalczyk on the floor. Big hit. Walking down the slot. Brian Berman again with the puck. There's Chris Puma chasing down Andrew Corvo. Corvo with the puck. He's going to do a little figure eight cut back into his own end and slow things down. 1:04 left in this first half. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Sorry. I've been a little dusty today. Corvo with a behind-the-back pass. That goes over to Brian Berman. Berman now back to Corvo. Working their little magic there. 45 seconds. Eddie Lombago will rub Corvo out. Corvo goes down. That was Lombago, actually. As Lombago tried to push the net off its moorings, but Lee Henson immediately adjusts it so there's no whistle. If you're just joining us tonight, ladies and gentlemen, our score is 1-1. Seconds left here in the first half. There's a shot by Brian Berman as he bumps Luke Storno. Looks like we're going to finish this first half 1-1, ladies and gentlemen. Again, thank you for tuning in. End of the first half. Our score, it's the Orange County Cowboys 1, the Chicago Carnage 1. We're going to pause for commercial break. We'll be right back on the RollerHockeyTV.net network.
Hi, I'm Joe Norris. I have played professional ice hockey, roller hockey, and been around hockey my whole life. And when I'm a little too tired to get up and play, I watch RollerHockeyTV.net because it is the bomb.
Whenever I'm online, I go to RollerHockeyTV.net.
Hi, I'm Philip Pritchard. When I'm not carrying the Stanley Cup, I'm watching RollerHockeyTV.net.
I'm Austin Cole.
I'm Dylan O'Malley.
And I'm Peter Jonah.
And we're with Hexa Hockey. And you're watching RollerHockeyTV.net.
Hi, this is Brian Steiner with the Anaheim Bullfrogs. And I'm here to say that I play for Casey.
Hi, my name's Jamie Cook, and I play for Casey Strail.
Places I remember all my life, though some have changed, some forever, not for better. Some have gone and some remain. All these places have their moments. With lovers and friends, I still can recall. Some are dead and some living. In my life, I've loved them all. But of all these friends and lovers, there is no one compares with you. And these memories lose their meaning when I think of love as something new. I know I'll often stop and think about them. In my life, I love you more. think about them.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, as period two is underway. 16:40 left. Goalie timeout here. Welcome back. Tonight, Major League Roller Hockey bringing you this action from the rinks in Irvine. North American Championships. The Orange County Cowboys lead the series 1-0. So obviously, if the Cowboys win this game, it's important to tell you that they will advance tomorrow to the breakaway bullies. If the Carnage win this game, then they're going to force game three to be played. So we look to see what will happen there. Berkeley Hoagland on the bench for the Cowboys. Kenny Van Skye on the bench for the Carnage. Again, Hoagland having that opportunity to run those late line changes that he does so often. Carnage being the home team gets a last line change. They should be taking advantage of that. Oh, there's a great play by number 81 of the Carnage to pick up a bad pass. Here goes Derek Bowles now with a full head of steam. Bowlesy comes down. He's going to go to the outside. He's got Luke Storna with him. Walks in. There's a shot. Big save by the goaltender for the Carnage there as he kicks that one out. Here's another opportunity as Bowles walks in backwards. Takes two guys with him. Correction, that was Luke Storna, not Derek Bowles. He's going to take that pass. If you're watching the game, you notice it's a little bright out here. Yeah, it's been a very bright day here in Irvine. Temperatures in the high 80s. Players out here, 15-16 left in this game. Cowboys' Pat Tyson with a nice shot. There's a high stick as the puck gets knocked down. That's going to be waved off as one of the Cowboys has touched it. And here comes the Carnage now on a two-on-two attack. Number 11, Ronnie Green, as I said, one of the top snipers for the Chicago team. Playing the Cowboys much better this game. I'll tell you, Kenny Van Skye's pep talk worked. Oh, there's a great move inside, outside. And a big save by the Chicago goaltender as he comes up huge. Full blast of steam there by number four. That's Jimmy Hawker. Boy, did he turn the Jets on. Great job. Bob Swab will take the faceoff. Puck will come back. Jimmy Hawker now tees it up. Goaltender again has it. He'll wave it down. Great to see Chicago fans here. They came and made the trip to watch their beloved team. About 250 people here in attendance. Thank you for tuning in and joining us tonight live from the rinks of Irvine. Major League Roller Hockey comes to you. There's a walk-in opportunity. Shot and a goal. Bob Swab will score, number 11. As he puts a nail in it, not the proverbial coffin, but as he puts a nail in, and I'll tell you, he hammered that puck. So no disrespect to the Carnage. Nobody would have stopped that. That was a goal in any league. He blasted that puck. So Chris Puba will get the assist. So Robert Swab scores what will be the game-leading goal for the Orange County Cowboys with 13:31 left to play. In the second half, ladies and gentlemen. So, we want to thank, obviously, Eddie Lumbaga and his staff here at the Rinks of Irvine for all their help this year. Dave Sr., Greg Martin, everybody here at the Rinks has been so wonderful to work with. They've just been awesome. Angel, John Rios, just great guys. The scorekeepers, and Chicago will knot it up. There's a goal by Chicago, and Corvo now. Corvo and Puma are going to square off. Puma, he's throwing some punches. They drop the gloves and go. Chris Puma now. Puma's helmet comes off. Obviously, MLRH instigator rule. Puma would get an automatic 2 minutes. Puma gets an automatic 2 minutes because he engaged Corvo with a helmet and cage on. So we're going to wait to see what the officials are going to assess here. So Chris Puma and Andrew Corvo get into it. Pretty good fight. Little scrap there, nothing wrong with that. Andrew Corvo standing up for his teammates, and Chris Puma, again, being involved in the penalty. So both players are going to receive 5 for fighting. And yeah, the helmet. He gets 2. So with that, ladies and gentlemen, waiting for the outcome here with the officials. So Chris Puma wearing the additional face shield. But we're going to use this opportunity to pause for a commercial break. We'll be right back on the RollerHockeyTV.net network.
It's Tim McManus from State Wars Hockey.
I'm Heather Josie Moore.
And I'm Aaron Honto.
I'm Sean Riley from Bauer Hockey.
Hi, I'm Kevin Labeda.
And I'm Rob with Labeda.
RollerHockeyTV.net.
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 This is Tim McManus from State Wars Hockey.
I'm Heather Josie Moore.
And I'm Aaron Honto.
I'm Sean Riley from Bauer Hockey.
Hi, I'm Kevin Labeda.
And I'm Rob with Labeda.
RollerHockeyTV.net.
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 This is Tim McManus from State Wars Hockey.
I'm Heather Josie Moore.
And I'm Aaron Hunt.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, the referees have sorted it out. Lee Henson has made the correct call. Chris Puma gets an additional 2-minute minor for having a half shield on and engaging Andrew Corvo. Corvo not wearing a half shield, which is why he was not assessed the penalty. This will basically put the Cowboys on a 4-on-3 disadvantage. So referee Henson has explained himself. They're going to drop the pucks. 4-on-3 advantage for the Chicago Carnage as they scored. Looks like Brian Berman got that goal, ladies and gentlemen, for the Chicago Carnage. So Berman scores to tie the game 2-2. Puma will get 5 for fighting and an additional 2 minutes for wearing a visor. Corvo will just get 5 for fighting. It always amazes me how people just walk around here and just walk into the score booth like they're gonna, it's just, I guess that's one thing, that's our fault for not putting the chain up. But they had a disgruntled parent just go into the score booth to yell at the referee over the call, and wow. They take their hockey serious here, folks. Still love this place. Eddie Lombaga's the bomb. Great guy, great facility. His staff is amazing. Greg Martin, everybody else. Anyway, 12:44, 1:45 left on the power play as Chris Puma got the additional 2 for instigating the fight and wearing a visor. Great call by Lee Henson and Brad Dedarian out there and following the rules precisely. If you have a shield or a half K or a any sort of shield, doesn't matter if it's a full or half, and you fight, if you don't take that off, you're going to get 2. Now the Cowboys are trying to scream for an offside, saying that the Carnage had to tag up. Andrew Skoron there makes a big save. 2-2, 12:07, 1:10 left on the power play. If you're just joining us, ladies and gentlemen, the Orange County Cowboys are up 1-0 in the series. 2-2, 11:50 left to go in the second half. 50 seconds left on the power play. Carnage came here, dropping game 1, 5-2. Now they're going to slow it down. Brian Berman is going to be the quarterback. He's on top. Obviously, Corvo being in the box hurts the Carnage because he's their goal scorer. And think about it. If that was a coaching strategy, it was brilliant because when you eliminate the top goal scorer, things become a lot easier. Uh-oh. There's Eddie Lombaga with a heavy shot as he uncorks it shorthanded. Eddie Lombaga out here, as you know, the general manager of the Rinks Irvine, has quite a few kids in attendance tonight watching him play. They all came out to see Eddie. There's a walk-in slide move by the Carnage, and they're going to score a power play goal to make it 3-2, ladies and gentlemen. So, 10:56, a power play goal for the Chicago Carnage has made it a 3-2 Carnage lead. Woo! 10:44 left. Carnage is up 3-2. Timeout, Orange County Cowboys. So we'll wait for the official word on that power play goal. But looks like Mike Kowalczyk will get that one as he scores and snipes on the power play. Great time here. I've just been joined by some young hockey players from the rinks who have come over to say hello. They're playing games on the next rink and just wanted to see what we're doing. Well, it's always great to see kids that are enthusiastic about playing this great game of hockey. So 10:40 will be the stoppage time as we wait for this timeout to end. Meanwhile, let's thank another one of our big sponsors, Monkey Sports. .10:40, 2-2 our score, period two here, the Rinks of Irvine, ladies and gentlemen. We are live. Thank you for tuning in and joining us tonight here, Major League Roller Hockey, North American Playoffs. The Orange County Cowboys are leading the series 1-0 as they won game one 5-2. And right now the Carnage are up on top 3-2 after they scored the power play goal by Mike Kowalczyk. Well, let's watch what the Carnage does. Is it going to slow it down a little bit in their own end? Look for an opportunity. Corvo and Puma still in the box. They're waiting for their fighting majors to expire. They'll have to wait for a whistle, and then they'll go out into the play. Again, we hope you're enjoying tonight's webcast. Our well wishes go out to Bill Rowie. We want to, obviously, Bill had emergency jaw surgery. So, Bill, our thoughts and prayers are with you for a complete recovery to what happened. Cowboys are going to try and slow things down a little bit. 9:46 left in the second half, or should we say the game, or regulation. There's Derek Bowles with a nice inside-outside move. Eddie Lombaga now. There's Luke Storno, and Storno isn't going to take it here. I tell you, he's the wrong guy to mess with. Luke Storno is a big boy protecting Eddie Lombaga, the captain of the team. So Storno in there talking to everybody. Berkeley Hoagland is yelling for the clock to stop. The referees are trying to clean the mess up, so they're not going to stop it. 9:06, ladies and gentlemen. 3-2, the Chicago Carnage are on top. Great game here at the Rinks of Irvine. If you're just joining us this afternoon, the Chicago Carnage lost game one 5-2. They looked a little tired. This game, they completely played a different style. So here they are coming out. Chris Puma got in a scrap with Andrew Corvo. Both players will be out with a whistle. They should be coming out waiting for the whistle. There's a pickoff. Ronnie Green now down for the Carnage with a behind-the-pack pass. As Derek Bowles now for the Cowboys is going to return. He passed over to Matt White. There's Matt White. Matt White with the puck. Down deep in the corner, trying to work some magic. Here they go, they head back down, in shot. Oh wow, Carnage almost buried another one as number 11, Ronnie Green. He's got some great hands down low. Ronnie Green one of the players on the Carnage that really makes it worth watching them. That and Andrew Corvo. So as soon as they get that whistle, we'll have both those players out. There's Skippy Tatasian trying to chase number eight, Brian Berman. Berman down the far side, takes a shot. That's going to go wide. Hey, there's a bad angle shot that will bounce and go wide. 7:30 left in the game, ladies and gentlemen. 3-2, the Carnage is up. James Stewart down there, shot on net, kicked out, making it look easy. Chris Puma and Andrew Corvo still waiting for the whistle. There it is, a penalty being called by Lee Henson. And Corvo and Puma will return to action. So they had their fight, they're done. As you know, Major League Roller Hockey, you're allowed one fight per game. A second fight by the same player will result in that player being automatically ejected and serving a three-game suspension. Oh, a face-off. 6:43 left to play. And with the score within two, our last 5 minutes are going to be stop time here, it looks. There's a nice move by Matt White. Goes to the backhand, and it just trickles over and went wide. Pat Tyson now down low. There's another shot. I tell you, the Cowboys are pressing right now for that next goal. Great game here, ladies and gentlemen. Just talking to our scorekeeper to remind him our last 5 minutes are stop time. Again, wishing Bill Rowey the best. When Bill's here, I have somebody helping me, and obviously with Bill being ill, we wish him the best with that emergency jaw surgery. Here come the Cowboys, trying to put a little heat on the Carnage, as the Carnage now is playing keep away. They're going to try and go into a defensive shell. By going into a defensive shell, they are going to obviously limit the opportunities of the Cowboys, but you know, they're playing deep. I think we saw what happened in Team USA with the women. There's a pass over to Bowles. Bowles just misses top shelf as he fires it from Skippy Tatasian. Brandon Brickley now, a nice give and go. Here's Brickley down the slot. That puck's going to be loose as Pat Tyson couldn't do anything with it. Tell you, he's got some great hands. There's a shot and a goal. And it looks like Derek Bowles from Skippy Tatasian will get the goal there. So congratulations, Derek Bowles lights the lamp to make it 3-3. And 5 minutes on the nose as we go to stop time. So that means every whistle will have us at a stoppage. The crowd here going crazy. There's a dump in the corner. I'll tell you right now, 4:52 left to go. We're on stop time here, folks. 3-3. If we are tied at the end of regulation, we'll play sudden death until we have a winner. We do not go to shootouts. It's the only way to do it. No game should be decided by a shootout in the playoffs. So sudden death overtime. We'll see what happens. Sorry, ladies and gentlemen, there as the Carnage now trying to make something happen down deep. They're going to work the puck. And now, 3-3, our score deadlock. Game one went to the Cowboys. Game two, the Carnage has had the lead twice, but they've just not been able to hold it. Oh, James Stewart with an inside-outside. It's a great play by Stewie. Eddie Labaca hits the post as he fires a high, hard snapshot. Puck's going to come all the way back down as the Orange County Cowboys will pick it up. Brandon Brickley will bring it back up. Over to number seven, there's Stewart. Stewart hitting the outside of the net as he takes a snapshot from a bad angle. Pass over to Brickley. There's Brandon Brickley again. He's going to walk down the lane. Takes it, he goes to the outside. It's a backhand shot. That's kicked out by great save by the goaltender for the Carnage. 3:21 left to go. Big hit along the boards. Jimmy Hawker takes the worst of that one. Here goes Ronnie Green now. He's going to try and work some magic. Ronnie Green going to the outside. The save by Andrew Skorin. 3:08 left in this regulation game. Remember, if we're tied, we go to sudden death overtime. There's a face-off that's won by the Cowboys. Chris Puma back on the floor. A couple new facial injuries after that fight with Andrew Corbo. There's a play by Tyson to Puma, trying to set Puma up. Chris Puma had some great heroics in Huntington Beach, ladies and gentlemen. He scored the hat trick in the game, including with 5.6 seconds left against the Las Vegas Battalion to tie the game up. Brian Berman loses the puck as it goes off his stick, but Puma scored with 5.6 seconds left in the game to tie it. And then in overtime, James Stewart scored from the center red line on a slap shot, beating Eric Hernandez after Berkeley Hoagland had completely unraveled Hernandez by chirping him the whole game. 2:26 left to go. 3-3 our score. The Carnage and the Cowboys. Obviously, the Carnage adjusting their game plan. Kudos to Coach Kenny Van Sky for doing it. There's a tee and a shot. That's blocked. Here goes Puma. Puma being chased by Brown. Tell ya, the Carnage got back quick. That was a great play by Tim Staley. Get back, he was a back checker there as a shot goes wide over the top of the net as Matt White just missed. Jimmy Hocker now down low. Matt White with the puck. There's White over to Hocker. Hocker with a shot and saved by the goaltender. So 1:51 is left in the game, ladies and gentlemen. 3-3 our score. Looks like both teams looking to make line changes. Lee Henson will bring the faceoff to the outside. Again, if you're just tuning in tonight, the Orange County Cowboys are leading the series 1-0. Chicago Carnage in a must-win situation here at the rink, Irvine. I want to thank the staff here again for everything. Rob Chornemann at LaBeta and Sean Riley, Frankie Negretti at Mission Bauer, along with Georgie Barber for everything they've done for us this season. Thank you so much, guys. Puck's down deep in the corner. There's Skippy. Oh, a little hookage by Skippy. No penalty call. Good play by the Carnage now. And nice shot put on net. That's going to go out of play. 1:24 left in regulation. Lee Henson talking to our scorekeeper, who's done a great job tonight. Thank him for everything he's done. Face off to the right of Andrew Skorin. Tell you, he's been red hot in these playoffs. Andrew has played so well for this Orange County Cowboys team. And let's not discount the goaltending of the Chicago Carnage. Now here's an opportunity for the Cowboys. Trying to set something up. James Stewart now with the puck. That's going to bump. Looks like Matt White is going to take it over to Stewart. Here's Stewart. Remember, he scored the big overtime game winner as he tried to feed Skippy Tatasian, who wasn't able to do it. And I apologize for mispronouncing his name. Tatavian, if I didn't say it correct. I apologize. Here's a 3-2-0. James Stewart in. He hits the post. He was in on a 2-on-0. A man wide open, and Stewart hits the post. Berkeley Hoagland is pulling out his hair on the bench right now. That would have been the game winner right there if he had made the pass. 23 seconds left to play in this game. As the Cowboys finish their hits, looks like, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to be going to sudden death. There's a pass and a shot. Skorin will make the save. Whistle with 6.3 seconds left. And you have to ask yourself, James Stewart had the game right there with Skippy Tatavian with him. And Stewart neglects to shoot the puck instead of going to Skippy for an empty net goal. That would have been the game, ladies and gentlemen. This could be a break Chicago has wanted and needed. It definitely has shifted the momentum, I'll tell you that. 6.3 left. Once these 6 seconds run down, if we don't have a winner, we are going to overtime. Thank you for joining us. And remember, Major League Roller Hockey, we've dedicated our season to Casey Strail. His memory, obviously, Casey Strail, a big part of the Rinks of Irvine, the Anaheim Ducks hockey program, started his ice with the Huntington Beach Lightning, and he touched so many people's lives. So we were very honored to dedicate our entire season to Casey Strail. Here we go. 6.3 seconds left. Faceoff is going to be to the left of Andrew Skoron. 3-3 our score. Next team that scores, I can tell you this, folks, next team that scores is going to win this game. It's a brilliant prediction. I think I'm going to go to Vegas. And they line up for the draw. There, the puck gets dropped, goes over the top of the net. Derek Bowles is going to go in the corner. Derek Bowles suffered a chipped tooth when he was in Huntington Beach. So the end of regulation, we're now going to play sudden death until we have a winner, ladies and gentlemen. We hope you're enjoying tonight's game from the Rinks of Irvine. And let's bring you Heather Josie Moore as she talks to you about why you should watch Roller Hockey TV. We'll be right back on the RollerHockeyTV.net network.
Hey everyone, Heather Josie Moore here, America's favorite hockey mom. Now we all know that moms know best, but hockey moms, we really know best. So where do I go when I want to find out what's going on in the roller hockey world? RollerHockeyTV.net, of course. Not only will you get the expert commentating of the one and only MLRH Commissioner Doug Jones, but you'll find out about all the latest and greatest product and equipment from their wonderful and amazing sponsors. Now, just like the world of roller hockey, RollerHockeyTV.net is not without its fun and shenanigans. We've got the great Berkeley Hoagland, who does Berkeley's Barbecue. Never a dull moment there. And then if you're extra lucky, you just might catch an episode of Heather's Hockey Makeovers, hosted by little old me. Now, whatever your need, you're sure to find what you're looking for at RollerHockeyTV.net. So tune in this week at www.rollerhockeytv.net. I'm Heather Josie Moore, and this message is Hockey Mom approved.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Sudden death overtime. Here we go. Lee Henson blows that whistle, and it's time to play. Next team, I can tell you what. Next team that scores is going to win this game, ladies and gentlemen. Here's Chicago as they pick up the puck. Go outside to the wide, I tell you. There it is! The Carnage have won in overtime. Ronnie Green has scored the goal. And our final score here, the Chicago Carnage 4, the Orange County Cowboys 3, ladies and gentlemen. We'll be back with game 2 at 7 o'clock. So we'll see you live at 7 p.m. Pacific time on RollerHockeyTV.net. Again, our final score from Irvine, the comeback and the Carnage. As I talked about, James Stewart having that opportunity to win the game. All he had to do was pass the puck, but he neglected to shoot that puck. Bad angle. It turns around, Carnage wins. Bang. We're going to game 3, ladies and gentlemen. Berkeley Hoagland now. Having a chat with some of the Carnage players in center. Great hockey here. The series is even and deadlocked. We'll see you at 7 p.m. Pacific Standard Time, ladies and gentlemen. Good night from Irvine for right now.